The State Minister for Ethics, Rose Lily Akello, has spoken of what she described as a great moral decadence in the country with regard to the levels of corruption that are currently being experienced. In the wake of the widespread interventions, including COVID-19 relief fund and the Emyoga, the minister was speaking in Gulu at the office of the Inspectorate of Government that records over 140 cases of corruption every single year. She said the country needs help.
In a bid to resurrect and uphold morally acceptable standards in the development of Uganda, the Minister of State for Ethics, Rose Lily Akello, is calling on Ugandans to look within themselves for change.
There's nobody in this room who can tell me that the morals of this country are like when we were born. There's a lot of moral decadence in this country. Our values are lost. How do we revive these values to come? It is me and you. And by the way, corruption is not like we are only stealing money. That is not corruption alone. You are deceiving me, you are already corrupt. You are picking this bottle from me and taking it there without the conscience or without asking. It is already corruption. So let's remove from our minds that if I embezzle ₦1 billion, that is corruption. What about that discipline, that bad character in you?
As she preached moral decadence in the country with examples of the COVID-19 relief fund and Emyoga cash, the minister noted that the country is being eaten up by corruption. However, 71-year-old Samuel Odun faults government agencies, especially the National Identification Registration Authority, the police and the Dormant Inspectorate of Government, IGG, for the escalating cases of corruption.
Minister, you have just told us you sit in the cabinet direct. Without any minister interrogating you. There is this thing in Uganda. In Uganda. Me, I'm talking nationally, not locally here. How do you people look at the 200 million in every session of new parliament, giving 200 million to members of parliament? How do you discuss that in cabinet? 200 million for a member of parliament who has just gone there, and then you give 200 million. How ethical is that?
In regards to the dress code of women, the Gulu City Council Deputy Speaker Lamek Sakena also places the blame on the colonial administration for the moral decay.
Say that the whites were very wise in disorganizing the African society. They came through women. And you know, if you go to the church, when the pastors begin to chase away demons, the women will fall fast. If the music is played here, the women will run and dance fast. Even in the dressing codes, if you look at songs and music which is on the screens, at least the men will have something good worn on them. The ladies will have their bikinis. I don't know how they are called.
The Gulu Regional Office of the Inspectorate of Government records a minimum of 140 cases of corruption each year. They also concur that there is rampant corruption across the country and public servants should start declaring their assets.
Not only do they fear to report, they fear to testify, they fear to provide information, they even fear to simply be seen with the investigators. You go to some of these places and you're conducting an inquiry and people simply fear to stand near you because they will be victimized by those who are watching them. As I speak now, we have, I think, over 300 case files of corruption at the office. And every year, Gulu Regional Office of the Inspectorate of Government completes a minimum of 140 case files of corruption and ombudsman nature on a yearly basis.
He also pinpoints at the fact that Ugandans are fearful of being responsible to report cases of corruption and human degrading tendencies. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.